Hello and welcome to Organic Edible Garden. This was our winter brassica bed and it's still going strong. We've had our super healthy collards here, which I just take the leaves off as I need them. Then we've had our beautiful Romanesco broccoli with their big floppy leaves. They're a great alternative to the cauliflower. And our sprouting broccoli, we had a really mild early winter this year and they didn't do as well as they should, but I've let them go to seed. This is good for two reasons. One, it's great for the bumblebees and the bees. They're just hovering around. Also, the roots give off a gas which sterilises the soil and prevents new weeds from germinating. And with this plant also, you can still use the flowers in salads. They taste just like broccoli, only sweeter. And then we had all of our cabbages. We've eaten all the green ones, but the little red ones are still here and they're super sweet. And in the bed next door, we've got our lupins. These have been growing for a few months now, and I want them to get a little bit taller. The general rule of thumb is if you let 10% of them flower, that's the maximum amount, because after that, all their stalks get woody and take a longer time to break down. I can chop it in now, but I don't need the bed for a while, and I want that to enrich the soil because I'm going to plant something like sweet corn, a really strong feeding crop in this bed. And this is a bed I had every intention to put lupins into, because leaving a bed like this fallow during the winter gets really compacted and acidic, and the worst of the weeds grow in it. So I'm going to do something about this bed. I'm going to turn it over with a fork and aerate it first, add some compost and some manure and some rock dust, and leave it to settle. But before we do that, we're going to take a soil sample and check the pH. If it is too acidic, we're going to add some lime to alkaline it. If not, and it is a good pH, we're still going to add some gypsum to it because we want to add that calcium to the soil. They're selling gypsum under the brand Claybreaker, but it's also Plaster of Paris and a few other names. Doing a test is really simple. These little kits do about 15 to 20 different tests. So what we need to do is get the little beaker out and put a bit of soil in it, preferably underneath. And add some of the powder. I'm going to add some liquid to that now and give it a good shake. We're going to leave this now for about 5 to 10 minutes and it should change a certain colour. We can check that on the chart to see what pH our soil is. One of the first things I'm going to do with a bed like that that's really heavy is aerate it with a fork. By putting the fork in and just moving it, I'm putting air down below. I'm not breaking the soil structure because the soil's so heavy and I can do damage. But by doing this, it's getting enough air down below so when we put our root crop in this bed, the roots will go down quite far. Later, it's come to a mild green, which is more of a neutral shade. It's neither acidic or alkaline, so I'm going to go for the clay buster or the gypsum over the lime. I'm just putting a couple handfuls per square meter. Remember, this is not going to change your pH at all, it's just going to add a good form of calcium. The next thing we're going to add is our rock dust. Not only does this make our vegetables healthy, but it's high in phosphorus, which is so important for our root vegetables. The other things I'm going to add to this bed are a couple barrels of compost. We need the carbon to go back into the soil after winter. And finally, we're going to add a wheelbarrow full of well-rotted chicken poo. This is going to add some nutrients into the soil, and over the next couple of weeks, it's actually just going to mix with the others and break down. And that's all that needs doing to this bed. We're going to let the rain and the weather do the rest, and in a couple of weeks it'll be ready for planting.